Welcome to another edition of our live Pittsburgh Sportsline in the BPTV studio. Thanks for watching. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. Chip Hayner's not here tonight. Smoking Jim Frazier's right there. Eating Olive Oil's Pizzeria, who sponsors this show. We'll talk about that in a minute. But thanks for watching us on Comcast 7, only in Bethel Park. Thanks for watching us on Verizon 32 in Bethel Park and all the way from Nemacolin to Cranberry, Wexford, and all points in between where they have Verizon. So check it out. Thanks for all the likes on Facebook. 6,872 likes. Appreciate you watching and liking our shows and liking our page. It means a lot to us. We've been doing this for 8 years. Come October. In October, we founded the show October 11, 2011. And no, Smoking Jim, that's not my birthday. We founded the show then. When I brought in cupcakes and different things and cakes, it was an anniversary of the TV show, not my birthday, which, as you know, is a few weeks before yours, June 30th. I didn't change it. It's still the same on Facebook, buddy. But since you got your Stevie Wonder look, I understand you have some vision problems, so I'll explain it to you again some other day, but that's what we got going on. We have some promos here. First off, let's see how this looks. I wanted to thank you guys for watching us, and thanks to Dave Cable. We're on HD tonight. Excuse me. So this will be, we're in the modern age, HD, or 4D and 4K. So we got HD, 4K, all this good stuff. And we got Olive Oil's Pizzeria sponsors our show with pizza and a hoagie. Smoking Jim's enjoying it right now. He'll be quiet for a couple minutes. So, but you can call them at 412-831-1900. Hillcrest Shopping Center. Smoking Jim knows where it's at. 5 minutes away from the studio here. You can't beat it, right on 88. Check it out. Next, we end each show with Stay Joey Strong. Joey Favis died before his 10th birthday because of brain cancer, DIPG. Picture of him before and after DIPG. His family's done some great things in the community, raising over $100,000. To find a cure for DIPG, the dreaded brain cancer that's a death sentence when they're diagnosed with it. Go to Joey Favis Childhood Cancer Foundation. Excuse me. You can donate a dollar. Check out their events. They have an event coming up in September, the 5K 1 mile walk. We filmed it each year. We'll do it again, so stay tuned for that. Next up is the Bethel Park Historical Society Arts and History Center, 2600 South Park Road, where the old trolley's at up there. It's parked in the front yard. You can't miss it. One of my favorite tea places is Reginald's Coffee. Check them out. That's 2600 South Park Road. They rent the place out for different events. They have all kinds of things there. There's a dance studio that performs there and practices. They have a nice history center there with uniforms, a library, so it's an interesting place. Check it out, 2600 South Park Road, Bethel Park Historical Society. Next up, the Bethel Park Community Foundation has money for you, from $100 to $5,000 for your group or organization, to help fund whatever you're doing good in Bethel Park, help to promote your organization and do well in the community. Get an application at bpcf.org. Come on in. I'm one of the trustees on the board. We'll hear what you want to do and see if we can get some money your way. Over $100,000 was given away last year to many needy people and organizations in Bethel Park. So check it out. Next up, Dave Cable likes to have a little fun at my expense. He put my face on Uncle Sam. Uncle Al, the talking machine, would like you for BPTV. You could be here like we got Zach here. We got Steve. We got maybe another Zach coming in. We got Jack coming in. So these guys help with audio and video, and this is all in 4D. Check out how crisp these pictures look here. I want you for BPTV, 412-831-3304. Give Dave Cable a call and tell him you want to help be a volunteer at our BPTV studio. Thanks again for the community and letting us do this show. Every Tuesday night, we're live in the BPTV studio talking sports. I was outside of Wendy's the other day, and there's an old gentleman just standing there, and I said, "How you doing?" He goes, I'm doing well. He goes, "I got a guy that's giving you a call." I go, "Do you know who I am?" He goes, "You're Al Levine, the talking machine."
Wow.
So he's standing out there in the sun warming up because he's an older gentleman. He's a little chilly. And we had a good conversation, and that was great. Then I'm at an event for Jessica Lee at Dorothy Six Cafe in Homestead. She introduced me to a couple of people that live in Bethel Park. And I said, "I have a TV show there." They go, "What channel?" I said, "Verizon 32. They go, "We got it. We'll check you out." So hopefully they're watching Verizon 32 tonight. Ran into a couple other people, same story. Some of them said, "We already watch you. You don't have to tell us about you. We like the show." They go, "Who's that character that's with you?" I go, "Chip Hayner." They go, no, the other guy. I said, "Smoking Jim Frazier." So we got some fans out there. Appreciate you guys listening and watching the show. Our What's On Your Mind is sponsored by Skeets Lewandowski of Skeets Service Station. It's a red, white, and blue station past Tracks Farm, Mineral Beach, the Dairy Queen. You can't miss it on the right side of the road heading out towards Finleyville. They work on anything and everything that runs on gas. You name it, they work on it. They even have a drive shaft, Pittsburgh drive shaft company. I was there the other day, an order came in for the first drive shaft that they're putting on a vehicle. So they do it all. They've helped me out with different things, so I appreciate that. But call them at 724-348-4715. And it's 7 miles from my house in Bethel to their place in Finleyville there. So check it out. We're going to start this show right now. Smoking Jim Frazier. What's on your mind?
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green,
coming at you.
You got to see Levine. Back to my old high school quarterback option days.
Hold on. What year was that? Hey, what year was that picture in the Facebook there? Number 22 was looking stylish on a kickoff return.
I tell you what. Oh, that one, yeah.
Yeah, the one you posted there, you won't say what year. It's unbelievable.
But
one interruption.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You, Mary Ann, for cutting my hair at Isuzu.
Looks good. Looks
got
good.
A great cut today. Look at that on HD. She's there every Tuesday at Isuzu. If you want Mary Ann to cut your hair, give her a call. She's there on Tuesdays.
Do they cut black hair?
Yeah.
Everybody don't do
She'd
that.
She'd like to get a hold of that knucklehead you got. She'll sign up to do that. She might give you the talking machine discount. We could do that. And shout out to their owner, Emilio. Nice guy, great owner, good man. He can cut some hair. All right, Smoking. What is truly on your mind?
Well, I tell you what, we might have a new rookie of the year. Oh, my man Zach did the impossible. You know, and I won't mention what he did.
Just mention it.
But he found the impossible. He ended up finding Three black Beckys.
Yeah.
Isn't that incredible? Searched the world over. He was able to do it. Gave him a homework assignment, and he came back. Job well done. Nobody could do it. I've been asking this question.
You've been trying for a month.
I've been trying for 10 years.
No way. You just had the dream. You just had the dream a month ago.
Zach's the only one that did it this last decade, man. Great
if you
job.
Don't know Smoking Jim, he's an entertainer. He's normally a quiet mother's boy, mama's boy, don't say much. But when it gets to some entertainment, he lies like the best of them. He could be the next president of the United States.
I ain't talking Look about Baltimore.
Look at that. Who even mentioned that?
But hey, I got an assignment for Steve Fisher. He's getting big time, making commercials, doing a lot of great things.
Yeah, what happened?
And I played the lottery for the first time in my life. Al Levine, the talking machine. I put 50 cents straight in 50-cent box. That's why I need Steve Fisher, if he can, to pull up the lottery to see if I won. I played the number 4864. 48-64. That's the Pirates record. You know, every day I'm going to play the Pirates record. Al Levine, the talking machine. I've been pretty good on my Pirate predictions over the last 25-plus years. And
folks, let me put the disclaimer out. If you don't bet, don't start. If you are going to bet, do the opposite.
Is my number 78 looking pretty good for wins?
I can't make a comment on
that. I'm getting ready to cash in, LB.
You should cash in. Take that ticket in there.
But I tell you what.
What?
A lot of people are predicting that Troy Polamalu, who the Pittsburgh Steelers have been backstabbing for the last 5 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Won't even put him in their little Steeler Hall of Fame. They said he's going to be a first ballot Hall of Famer next year.
Really?
So as much as I love Troy, and as great as Troy is, and Troy is a friend of mine, I don't think there should be any safety in the Hall of Fame before Donnie Shell's. A shame Donnie Shell's not in it. If you're going to put a strong safety in there, I'd like to see Troy and Donnie Shell going together.
Smoking Jim, you like to bring out these curses, discrimination. There's actually a prejudice in the Hall of Fame with putting Steelers in.
Wow.
Too many guys from one team. They don't want to put any more in.
Wow.
That's what's been happening.
But they're putting Troy in.
Hold it, from the Super Bowl era.
Oh, okay. Okay.
To think back. Okay. You know, you were a little kid in diapers. Those Super Bowl guys, they don't want to put them all in there. They should be. What about L.C. Greenwood?
Yeah, L.C. Well, you know, I interviewed L.C. Greenwood, and he's in Canton. He said whether he goes to the Hall of Fame or not.
His shoes.
He said, not just that. He said whether I go to the Hall of Fame or not, he said when I get buried, I'll be buried in Canton, Mississippi, and that's where he's buried at.
But
so he's
we're
in
talking
Canton.
Ohio.
Okay, yeah, sorry, that's a little different.
Sorry.
But yeah, LC should be in. But nobody
I mean,
should be.
That's just two right off the top of my head that should be in there.
Andy Russell.
There's another guy.
You know, I'm always.
How can you hold him out?
Yeah, I'm always looking for the reverse discrimination. There it is there.
I know. Did you find it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But there's a prejudice.
How about Clay Matthews?
There's a prejudice. Well, no, he's not a Steeler. There's a prejudice against Steelers.
Yeah.
I want it to be known here.
You're right. In the Super Bowl era.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, Al Levine, the talking machine, I don't want to hog up the show.
No, you got extra time because I'm giving you chips time.
But nobody can feel those.
I'm giving it.
But I tell
I'm
you
giving
what,
it.
I had a dream come true this weekend.
This isn't Black History Month.
That's not Black History Month. I was the master of ceremonies at the Oakmont Country Club in El Levine, the talking machine. I tell you what, I done been to the Rose Bowl, I done been to the Sugar Bowl, I done been to the Cotton Bowl, I done been to
the
Super Bowl, Orange Bowl, but I never thought I'd be at Oakmont Country Club for three reasons. One, I ain't a good golfer.
You don't even golf.
I don't even golf. Number two, Oakmont's one of the greatest golf courses in the world. And number three, I never made it past Oakmont Bakery. So it's the first time. I didn't even know it was so close. I didn't even know. It was right off the main road.
Yeah.
I go there and I, You know, I didn't want to spend too much money, so I didn't valet park. I walked the extra 10 feet. They're like, well, you can valet park there, or you can park here. I'm like, oh, I'll park here. So since my car looked like a golf cart anyway, about the same size, I got there. I tell you what, El Levine, the talking machine, it was great. They tried to play the brother.
What happened?
I had to put my foot down, El Levine. Almost had to take my sunglasses off, El Levine, the talking machine. They tried to give me salmon. I said, the brother won filet mignon. And I tell you what, that was so good. You could just put a fork on there.
What, salmon?
And it just cut the filet mignon. It was so good, and it had the...
It was tender.
Extra whipped potatoes.
Really?
Oh, it was good. I left the salad for somebody else. I figured the guys in the back room, they had that salad. Everybody kept saying, you going to eat your salad? No. So the salad and the rolls, I saved it for the dishwasher.
If I'm you, here's what I got. Do you think I'm a salad guy? You can use that. You can steal that off
me. And then they tell me at the last minute, I could have had an and one. If I'd have known that, I could have brought you, or I could have brought a Steel City Beauty.
Oh, man, I'd have fit in right there.
Man, no doubt about it, but it was a beautiful place.
I would have fit in with all the other white guys.
I'll tell you
if you can bring up the race, I can bring up the race card.
And I looked at all the pictures on the wall. I ain't seen one brother.
I had to say it before you did.
Some good pictures, man.
I'll bet.
But, hey, that's what's on my
what
mind.
What did you even talk about there?
Oh, my goodness. El Levine, the talking machine. I tried to get out of it. I couldn't get out of it. I turned it down about
Who
three.
Who brought you into this?
Three or four times. I don't even know how they got my name, El Levine, the talking machine. I thought they was playing a joke on me at first, so I verified
it.
And I tell you what, I'm glad I couldn't get out of it. And
did they even pay you?
Pardon me?
Did they pay you?
No.
Most master of ceremonies
get a
token.
Yeah.
They get a token.
They get a token. I didn't get nothing, man. It was on the clip.
Smoking Jim, next time tell them to call me.
Yeah, I said my agent.
I'll negotiate for you.
Maybe that's why I got the job. They figured the price is right, you know?
I'd have at least told them $20 and two filet mignons.
Yeah. It was a standing room only crowd. It was a lot of fun. I had a great time, man.
Did you tell any stories?
You know what? I told some stories, but I
had
some fun.
How did they even fit in?
It didn't, because I tell you what, the people who went up before me, before we ate dinner and everything, you know, they're telling these golf stories, and I can't relate, man.
You like Tiger Woods.
Yeah.
You could have told a Tiger story.
Yeah, but it was fun, man. I had a good time. Met a lot of good people, man. And there was a lot of girls in tight dresses.
No way.
They don't mind wearing them tight. They don't mind wearing it tight now.
Well, that's good. Did you get any pictures with new sweeties?
No, I didn't do that, but I did get a picture, one picture with the Oakmont sign behind me. So that
Proved
was good.
You there.
Yeah, so
you
I had
to
a,
verify it.
Had a great time, man. Didn't pull a Batman. I was there. I was almost last one to leave.
No way.
Yeah, I was hoping.
I'm glad I taught you something.
I was hoping they had a couple brothers in the kitchen that could have brought me out some more filet mignon. I was laying low to see if they, but they didn't.
You outsmarted yourself
again. Yeah, give me one to go. It was so good. I've never had filet mignon before.
Never.
You know, I'm a T-bone man.
Are you?
I guess it's a little cheaper cut.
It is. I like the filet mignon. I get it rare.
Oh, man.
I get it rare. Seared on the outside, rare.
Well, they didn't even ask me what I wanted, but it was good. However they fixed it, I don't know how they did it. It wasn't rare.
Well, luckily you got your sunglasses on, so you didn't see the blood the blood dripping there.
It was so good, man.
Good.
It was so good. Maybe in September we can suggest that our friend Bill Boyce fix us a couple filet mignon.
Yeah.
And he already has some homegrown tea that he can make for us.
Yeah. You could ask him there for Labor Day.
Yeah. And that's what's on my mind. Thanks, LLV and the Talking Machine. Thanks, Zach.
I'm glad we got through all this. Smoking Jim. What's on my mind is the Pirates. I've officially said they're not going to make the playoffs because there's no way winning only four games and losing all the rest coming back. It's been disappointing. There's some moments they shine, but it just crushed me last night when Jordan Lyles come back and he wins a game against us. Unbelievable. We gave up like five runs or so in the first inning or so, and just a terrible performance there. That's what's on my mind. The demise of the Buccos, Smoking Jim's on that bandwagon. Strong. People know it everywhere. Not more than 78 wins. It sure looks like that. Definitely, Smoking Jim. You may have your first winner with the Buccos. But that's what's on my mind. We'll be back with some fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac.
Hi, Bethel Park. Remember me? My name is Jason Planitzer. I was the host of a little show here. You may have seen it. It was called the Jason Planitzer Show.
What would you say your experience at BPTV, how has that had an impact on your life?
I found my voice. I learned how to be funny. I learned how to create things. I learned how to collaborate with people here. I developed an interest in film and comedy and making videos. It stuck with me. It continued through my life. I got into working on motion pictures. I now I'll produce small videos. I'll work with producers on commercials, television projects, feature films. I scout locations on TV shows and movies, which involves me reading scripts, finding the locations that need to be shot, and collaborating with the director and production designer to find the perfect spot. It all started at BPTV for me.
Thanks, L. Levine, the Talking Machine. Thanks, Rookie of the Year, Steve Fisher. You're going to be hearing from him. Check him out on some of these commercials.
Thanks. And movies. Movies, too.
That's it, movies. Thanks to the new Rookie of the Year, Zach, came through strong for me. How about my man, Lil Z, Zach Taylor, out there helping out as well. But the fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac, I got an uncle. Lives in Johnstown, but he's from Newport News, Virginia. They retired his number at his high school before they tore it down.
Good.
And he's in their Hall of Fame in Newport News, Virginia. But when he played football, he was so violent that even Jack Tatum and Dick Night Train Lane said, that's a little too violent.
No way.
He was one of them type guys, but they honored him 2 weeks ago in Johnstown.
Wow.
Along with Artrell Hawkins, who used to play for the Cincinnati Bengals. And I made sure that I went up to him and congratulated him in only Smoking Jim style. Your dad was 10 times better than you. the original Hawk. If he had had the grades, he'd have made it all the way. I don't know if you remember Artrell Hawkins back in the day. Was a great, great running back. Had like most people in Johnstown, he had no grades to go on to the next level. And also, they honored Carlton Hasselrig.
No way.
Carlton Hasselrig still looked good. I remember watching Carlton Hasselrig.
Wrestling.
Well, I remember when he was in high school. They had a pretty good running back at Johnstown at that time. It was going to Lock Haven, and Carlton was going to go to Lock Haven and play football as well. But the one thing that they have in Johnstown is plenty of floods and beautiful women.
Really?
So he didn't want to leave the girls, but they didn't have any wrestling. At but he played in the Big 33 game, which was played in Johnstown his senior year.
What a coincidence.
And he was like Aaron Donald on the football field, but he decided to go and wrestle. Now, Johnstown, when he was in high school, didn't have wrestling. So he went independent his senior year, was a state champ. So he went on to wrestle at Pitt Johnstown. How they kept him eligible for 4 years is a mystery. I think he's 3 years away from a degree. But
that's close.
But he's he broke a record in college. He was a six-time All-American. He would win the Division II All-American championship. Then he would win the Division I. And if it wasn't for Chuck Noll pulling him into the NFL, he'd have probably been Olympic champion along with Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle was a heavyweight. Carlton Hasselrig was the number one super heavyweight in the world. Used to beat the Russians and all them during the summer. But the one thing about all the Hasselrigs, so if you ever meet a Hasselrig, don't buy them a drink. They all got, there's something in their blood, in their DNA, that they go crazy when they drink.
Okay.
And that's passed down from generation to generation. That's something you know. Anybody named Hasselrig.
Really?
Don't drink with them. Or get out of the bar. They're drinking. Get out of there because they're going to go crazy. And you remember Hasselrig would drive his Jeep down the steps of the library Pitt and all that. But Chuck Noll, the great Chuck Noll, brought him in. Here's a guy who never played offensive line in his life. He ended up being a top offensive lineman in the NFL, all pro, Pro Bowl, all pro, until he started that drinking. And nobody understood why he left the NFL.
Yeah.
He seen there was
a big.
He was
thirsty.
There was a big sign. There's a big billboard in Johnstown that said, "Drink Canada dry." So he did. He went to the CFL. He tore it up. I'm near hell with me, the talking machine. They couldn't figure out why would he leave millions on the table to go to Canada. But that's what he did. Even came back, did some jail time. Even came back, did some mixed martial arts and stuff like that. Tried to get back into studio wrestling.
Yeah.
But he just was past his prime at that time. End up marrying a girl from Monroeville.
No way.
Yeah. And I played a little bit of Harriet Tubman, Underground Railroad. I got her out of there. We got her to Atlanta. Hell, being the talking machine. She couldn't take it. She couldn't take it no more. The police wouldn't even come to the house because they were so scared of Carlton Hasselrig.
Wow.
And so we got her out of there. Just call me Harriet Tubman, brother.
How did she get her out of there?
She took the kids and everything else, man. She go and never look back. That's about 15 years ago.
Wow.
But hey, it was great to see him. He's doing well.
What did he think of you?
Well, you know what? He knew my family from Johnstown. Like I said, I seen him. My cousin, Phil White, was one of the greatest players ever to come out of Johnstown.
Really?
But he went to a high school called Forest Hills.
Wow.
So
how'd he travel?
Well, Forest Hills is in Johnstown, but it's all white, all white community, because my uncle got a lot of money.
Yeah.
And he was able to keep his grades up and go to the Army. End up making sergeant.
Good.
Yeah, did a few tours in Iraq. He had some football scholarships.
Yeah.
And but he got there and figured that algebra, he never would be able to pass algebra. So he, but that's what the recruiters do at a lot of colleges.
Oh, you couldn't Are pass you algebra.
Yeah. Are you from Johnstown?
It must be a gene in your family. You couldn't pass algebra either.
Never. Who needs it, brother? Who needs it?
You need it for a degree. You got 18 different degrees, general studies, general sue, all the rest. Yeah, unbelievable.
But that's the fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac. It was great to see those guys along with my uncle down there getting on.
Are you welcome in Johnstown or is it like Clareton?
Oh, my goodness. Woo! Yeah, it's, okay. I'm welcome, thanks to my all uncle, as long as I stay on the outskirts where the white folks are. Okay.
Thank you for bringing up race relations. In this day and age, we appreciate the melting pot that you're creating. Thank you, Smoking Jim Frazier. Welcome back. On location next Monday, August 12th, we'll be at 930 Brookline Boulevard, Olive Oils Pizzeria. I got a great guest coming in and a couple others. Attila Domos, the hand cyclist, just won the Pittsburgh Marathon hand cycling for the third time. He'll be there. Mark Caputo, that has a collectible sports collectible place at South Hills Village, he'll be in there. And Attila gave me a couple names of some champions. I think they do like inline racing or something. This Rob Campbell, he's won four or five national champions. And his wife, Nicole, she's won like four or five championships herself. So we should have a great show talking to them. And we're working on another guest or two also. So be prepared for August 12th, next Monday. Who would believe it's already August 12th?
I won't.
Where'd this month go, Smoking Jim?
Gone.
I know you can't see it, Stevie, but I'll tell you, that's next Monday. Be there 7:30 to 8:30. Plenty of great pizza, Italian food, different specials, and the Italian ice is some of the best you'll have in the city of Pittsburgh. I recommend it highly. $3 a cup of ice. Can't go wrong. I'm going to have one for sure. As warm as it is today, hot and humid, it affects me, the heat and humidity. But I get that suntan. How's that suntan look on HD
Great.
TV? Great. Look at that. No spray on. Regular tan. Cup of green tea and sun. Plenty of it. But then on location will be the 19th. Mark your calendar. The Millville VFW number 118. 605 North Avenue. We're coming back for Jose Carabello, his gym, and some guests we're working on being there. So it'll be a great show there at the VFW. Very historic building, over 100 years old. Great place. You have to check it out. Come on out there. If you're out in the North Hills, come on in. It's right in Millville. Can't miss that exit, 3B or whatever. So come see us in Millville. And it's a great night. We'll have a lot of sports talk. Great location there. Great people there that run it. And they enjoy Smoking Jim and Al Levine, the talking machine. And we'll have Jose talking again. And maybe he'll bring some more actors and producers in and whatever else he's doing out there. So we'll see what happens. That's on the 19th. So check that out. Looking at a couple other shows that we may do later in the month. And we'll see what happens with that stuff. But stay tuned for our on-location shows. And we'll be back with some Bucko Talk.
Bethel Park Inline Hockey. It's fast, it's fun, and we want you to play. Inline hockey is just like ice hockey, but no ice. And significantly less expensive and far less of a time commitment. Way less travel than ice hockey, too. The sport is played on a specialized rink at the Bridgeville Rollerplex, RMU Island Sports Complex, Harmerville's Alpha Arena, Hot Shots Indoor Sports Arena, and the Murraysville Sports Zone. Our teams play in the Pennsylvania Interscholastic Roller Hockey League, or the PIRHL. Each year, teams from elementary, middle, and high school play a 16-game schedule, plus playoffs, from October through March. Practice one evening a week and games on Saturdays or Sundays. The sport is recognized by the Bethel Park School District, which means student-athletes can earn a letter once they reach high school. We play rivals such as Upper St. Clair, Peters Township, Hanamack, Pine Richland, North Hills, and so many more. This is no pickup game. You'll need regulation pads, hockey skates, helmets, and the coolest Hawks uniforms around. Two refs at every game officiate three 15-minute periods with a running clock. No icing, no offsides, no checking. But this sport will rock you. Registration is coming up, so check out our website at www.bpinlinehockey.com and sign up soon. Let's play!
Hey, it's Christine from Bethel Park Library. I want to tell you about a great fundraiser we have going on. You can take home a print of this cute sloth, painted by local artist Maria Prasik, was inspired by Vivian, the sloth that lives at the National Aviary. The original painting will be housed at the Bethel Park Library forevermore, but you can own a 16 by 20 print for $50. You can purchase it at the Bethel Park Public Library or through the library's website at bethelparklibrary.org.
Welcome back. We're not going to talk much on the Buccos. I haven't posted many things. I have a Facebook page, Bucco Pride. Haven't put up too many things because they haven't been winning. Since the All-Star break, Smoking Jim's grinning ear to ear, they only won four games. So what was that number you played? 48-64?
Yeah.
It didn't come in. Save your money, folks. Whatever he's playing, do the opposite. Don't bet the pick four. That's it. He's out of control. Well, at least he only spent a dollar instead of $2.50. So he left $2.49 on the table. So I'm glad he walked away with that, I think. But back to the Buccos. Josh Bell's not hitting well. Pirate pitchers have all been hurt and injured. Brault's supposed to come back. Musgrove looked terrible in the last outing he performed. So they're not doing that well at all. Archer has been a problem all year, one of the worst trades we ever had. He just has not gotten people out, and he gives up more home runs than anybody. So he keeps trying, but I'm not seeing much satisfaction there. Brian Reynolds, it's great to see him hitting. Newman's playing well. It's just a tough team to watch because they're not playing well. Smoking Jim gets free tickets. He's not even giving them away. They're giving them back. So what's that tell you? If Smoking Jim can't give you a ticket to go to a game, what's going on? What do you think, buddy?
Well, Al Levine, the talk machine, like we talked about before, you know, the real baseball starts after the All-Star break. Pittsburgh Pirates have traditionally collapsed after the All-Star break. You don't go 20 straight losing seasons and go get yourself in the Guinness Book of World Records if you have all the answers.
That's old news, buddy. I'm talking now.
And they're starting a new streak. You know, the team's just, you got a couple of good players. Like I said before, as much as I love home run hitting, baseball's not about the home run hitting. It's about getting on base, about getting hits, about moving guys.
Well, you don't watch much baseball.
No, no.
But now it's all about the homer.
Well, they're setting records now for home runs, and I guess they figured out how to
They say the ball's juiced up.
Juiced up. They're setting they're breaking records, and Josh Bell, they're figuring out a way to pitch
Smoking
to him.
Smoking Jim, like all great hitters and pitchers, they always figure out the edge. They're throwing him a lot of curveballs, stuff off the plate, and he doesn't get much to even hit at. He might get one fastball or two fastballs during an at-bat, and they're out of the strike zone. That's what they're doing to him. So he has to compensate for it. Aaron Judge, when he was hitting all those home runs, started throwing the curveball, and you lost interest in Aaron Judge, when he didn't hit those home runs for a couple weeks. That's what they were doing to him.
Well, I think Josh Bell's problem was he got a little big-headed. He had that success early on.
He started becoming
a celebrity.
No, it's far from that. It's what they're throwing at him. If you watch the game and see how they pitch him, you wouldn't even say that. They're pitching everything away from him. Nothing good to hit.
Is he walking or just striking out?
He's walking, striking out, getting a single or two.
Oh.
Yeah, it's terrible, buddy. You got to watch a game once in a while. At least watch the first two innings.
Yeah, I've seen a few of his photos with the fans. I'm like, he's not focused.
He's totally focused in there. My man, he's working hard all the time. They're just pitching around him. Put it like this, when you have a team that's not hitting anything, it doesn't even matter. They walk him, whatever. Don't give him a good bat.
Is he going to get 30 home runs? He's on pace for about 50.
I don't know. He might. He needs three.
Is that all?
Yeah.
So he might get that.
He might get that, and he has 89 RBIs.
I'd like to see.
Nobody caught him yet. They're close. He's leading the league in RBIs still.
That's pretty good. They're closing in on him now.
Yeah. Well, there's still games to go. They could catch him, but, yeah, that's our Bucco talk. We'll see what happens. You know, to me, they're done. They're not going to make the playoffs or anything. There's no chance.
No leadership.
Well, I don't know about that. They have leaders, but I don't know where they're leading them to. Sometimes you just go through this. You know, we know how the management is or lack of management. I say the pitching coach got to go. Ray Searidge has used up his usefulness. I was watching Charlie Morton pitching the other day, throwing 95, 96 mile per hour fastballs. You know, it's just all your pitchers got hurt. I don't hear anybody in the local media talking about Ray Searidge as the blame for this or is behind some of this, because he got all the credit when they do well.
Mm-hmm.
All your starting pitchers are hurt. Tyon's not going to be back for 6 to 9 months. He's getting another operation, so, you know, that's not good. And Trevor Williams hasn't done well. Last year he was the best pitcher in the National League. This year he's not even close to that. So we got a lot of problems everywhere, top to bottom. So that's where we're at with the Buccos. We got Steeler talking, the NFL scout, Steeler scout, smoking Jim Frazier. Do you got any insights on the Steelers?
Well, I tell you what, L. Levine, the talking machine, I believe they got a game on Friday against Tampa
Bay. Yes, they do, against your legendary coach and hero.
Best, in my opinion, best coach in the NFL by far.
That's why I've tried to set it up for you.
Yeah, Bruce Arians is.
What has he done lately?
Well, he's a two-time NFL head coach of the year, and
what has he done lately?
I think he's going to work some miracles down there
in Tampa Bay.
I think he's going to do.
What are they going to win? 5 games?
He may. 6. He may work another coach of the year honor in there. I think one more coach of the year. They got to put him in the Hall of Fame, right?
No. It don't matter.
But, Elvin, while we're here, take your shoes and socks off. Show the fans out there the bottom of your feet. I'm going to compare it to Antonio Brown's.
Did
you see it?
I've never heard or seen a show like the Antonio Brown show. Those feet look terrible.
Wow.
John Gruden's disappointed and just can't believe this is happening. Well, to me, it's not a surprise. He rode a hot weather air balloon to training camp. One of those big balloons that they put hot air in.
Yeah.
He rode that to camp.
Wow.
And he hasn't been right since. It's a non-football injury that he has. He got stuff on his feet.
Why? Well, I got the scoop.
What is it?
I'm the only one that got the scoop.
All right,
everybody,
tell us.
Tune in. You got the scoop from the scout. What actually happened with Antonio Brown's feet. Antonio Brown gets in that, he's like James Harrison. They get in that oxygen, whatever that is.
Yeah, chamber.
Chamber, whatever, contraction, whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Chamber.
Ozone, whatever it
is.
No,
oxygen.
And you got to have proper footwear when you go in. And he didn't have proper footwear on when he went in there, so his feet are peeling. And it's painful. Who knows? I wouldn't even be surprised.
Misses a game.
If he has to miss a game or so. That's how bad it is. And so I'll find
I recommend him. He go to Reverse Aging Energy Spa in Bethel Park. Get the infrared sauna. Get a good sweat like I do.
Wow.
Come on up there. Your feet will be fine.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
It'll help heal you.
You didn't hear the latest about his kids, did you?
No.
You know, I got a little inside with the Hard Knocks people in the NFL.
What? You watch it?
Well, sometimes they leak a little something for me.
Good.
And Antonio got his kids at practice. Of course, he ain't practicing. They're
sure.
Asking him why he ain't practicing, you know.
He can't run.
He's saying his feet and problems with his feet. So then they ask, where's Ben Roethlisberger? Where's Roethlisberger? They want Roethlisberger. Where's Uncle Ben? They want Uncle Ben. He said,
the kids.
He said, we don't play. He said, we don't play. He said, I'm not with the Steelers anymore. I'm with Oakland.
They
kids
didn't know.
Are crying. They want Uncle Ben. They want Uncle Ben. So I don't know if that'll make it to Hard Knocks. Maybe I'm sure.
I don't think. I don't
think
they
might want to cut that out. But they want Uncle Ben. They done something. They like the kids. It's like, where's Ben Roethlisberger?
Wow. This is from the NFL scout, Smoking Jim Frazier. You don't hear this anywhere else.
Anywhere else.
They can't even make this up. Well, you could, but we're not checking the facts on this. 17 sources we need. I don't know how you get it. Now back to the Steelers. What are they doing?
Well, I tell you what. Pittsburgh Steelers are going to have one of the greatest offensive attacks in the history of the game. The only problem is to go to the Super Bowl, I think you need a Bell and a Brown, and they just don't have guys like that that can demand that kind of respect from a defense. But Dante Moncrief is going to have a breakout year. James Washington, in my opinion, is just going to destroy the National Football League this year.
Wow.
Juju, even though I don't like him, Juju is going to be an all-pro, play at all-pro level again. He got great size, ability. I'm so disappointed in Santonio Holmes. The Pittsburgh Steelers backstabbed you. You put a curse on the organization. Now he's there working with the receivers in training camp. Where's your pride? You know.
Your curse was a lie.
Yeah, the curse is still there.
No, the curse was a lie.
No Super Bowl win since they.
That was a lie. There was no curse. That's why he's working for the Steelers now. Because he said there is no curse.
He's doing that because he's out of the limelight.
There's no curse.
This is a guy that was a couple years ago was speaking at Stone Rocks High School. What's the bottom of the barrel you got to do to do that?
What was he talking about?
Where's everybody at? Was it 19 kids on the team?
If that. A couple coming off the stands.
Yeah. But I tell you what, James Conner, I can't say enough about him.
Except he's brittle.
Yeah, he's a brittle brother. He got a lot of problems. But this is a guy, you know, they honored some of the police officers and team came in. They got ready. They got focused. But James Conner went over before the drill started and shook every police officer's hand, which is really, really amazing. But, you know,
especially at this time in our country.
Yeah, this time in our country. It's something that it's just in him. Some guys just got it in them to do the right things at the right time
Like you.
And then there's other guys like Juju. If there ain't a camera involved in it, he's not going to do it. He wants a camera involved. He wants everything me. And
That fits in with today.
Yeah.
They all do that.
But then you got the greatest linebacker in Pittsburgh Steeler history, J.J. Watt.
What happened?
And he's ranked in the top 100 greatest players in the NFL right now, and he's up to 92. And guess who's the number one rated player in the NFL right now?
I don't know.
Of course, he didn't bust a grape in the Super Bowl, but Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald's number one. So congratulations to Aaron Donald. Here's a guy that was a two-star recruit.
You bum-wrapped him at Penn Hills, and you bum-wrapped him at Pitt till he graduated.
And he's the best.
Then you sucked up to his family after that.
Yeah. Still trying to get his dad in the Hall of Fame. Archie Donald was a great player.
I know. You came out on the bandwagon on that after disrespecting his son so much. I said, he's a great player. He'll do well in the NFL.
He did.
And he has, and he signed a multi-million dollar contract, and he waited out on that.
Well, you're only as good as your last game, and so hopefully that ain't a reflection. That ain't a reflection of things to come.
Maybe that's just a bad game. You're only as good as your last game, and that's why you're suffering like this. You won't even talk about it. Let's go back to that year. What year was that? Since you're being so honest here. What year were you at CalU?
But I'll tell you what, man. The Pittsburgh Steelers, their defense, is going to be lacking defensively.
Devin Bush is going to give him a little bit of an improvement.
Well, they're throwing a lot at the 5'11" linebacker that can't cover tight ends.
He won't need to.
Yeah, but that's what they're bringing him in. Shazier is working with him. That's another waste of time. I mean, it's just, you got coaches for that. You know what I mean? Shazier's no coach.
Shazier needs to do something.
Yeah, yeah.
He has a lot of energy, and he's healed up to a certain point, but he's not going to come back.
He made a baby.
Right, but he's not going to come back
he says
to the
he
NFL.
Is. He says he is.
One injury, and he's done.
Yeah.
One hit.
I don't think they'll ever let him come back. They keep him on a payroll.
Put it like this, the doctor's got to be telling him. You're not going to play.
Yeah.
But you can't. Your spinal cord's everything.
I think it's too late now.
What do you mean?
If he'd have been able to play, he'd have been playing by now, you know.
That's a severe injury.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can see it or not, but that was terrible.
Yeah, maybe make another baby.
He could do that.
Yeah.
Once you do one, you could do two.
Put all that energy. You
could do two.
Put all that energy to good use.
Well, he's working out, so he looks in good shape.
Yeah, the one time I seen him jump on something about this high.
That's good.
That was pretty good.
Just think if he fell.
Yeah.
Be back to the drawing board. You can't mess around with something like that. It's like these head injuries. Once you're getting all these concussions, look at these guys. Look at James Harrison. He gave out hundreds of concussions. What do you think he suffered?
None.
A lot of them. That's why he can't talk.
James Harrison can't talk?
Yeah.
He always talk like that.
He can't fly in an airplane to the White House. He couldn't fly to the White House. Yeah. Come on. He's afraid to fly.
He wouldn't go see the black president. Can you believe it?
I believe it. Why'd you have to mention black president? They're all our presidents. Unbelievable, Smoking Jim. What do you think the Steelers are going to do this year then?
Well, I think
are they going to get more wins in Cleveland?
Well, I'll tell you what. I think that. Oh, I'm losing the mic. I don't know where.
We can't even hear him. Where'd the mic go? Here. There's a wire here.
Who put that mic
on me? Hold it. Your chair is on there.
Who put that mic on me? All right, but.
Just talking to the mic.
Yeah. I think.
It looks good. On HD.
But I think the team to beat in the division is going to actually be Baltimore as well. Baltimore runs an offense that nobody else in the league runs.
They're figuring it out right now. What happens every year when an offense gets so far ahead of the defenses? They figure out how to cut them back.
Well,
and he's a one-trick pony, basically.
Well, if you study Vince Lombardi like I have and Chuck Knoll,
you
don't need many plays.
Did you watch him on film?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Film, study them on film. And when you're running, when you get in the mindset that you want to run, they can study all they want. They can't stop it. If you're determined to run the football, they ain't going to be able to stop it, especially in this day and age. So I think they got the running game. They got the quarterback. They're dedicated to the run. And the guy throws good enough at times that he can get a few passes.
I think he ranked 30th in the league.
Yeah, that's good enough at times.
You didn't know I knew a stat.
That's good enough at times.
My friends, I'm not an NFL scout. 30th in the league. How many teams are there?
32.
Thank you. That's 3-0 out of 3-2. I mean, there were only two other spots to go.
They don't have a great passing game.
I rest my case.
But that's
something to hold your hat on. He could throw.
He could throw at times.
He could throw. It was over 50%, so that was good.
And I think that, Cleveland's going to be a phenom. I think they got
on paper. They look great.
I think they got the Steelers' number. They got the most talent in the league. They got a tough schedule, though. So they got to get through the schedule. And
well,
they have
to get past the fact that they're Cleveland.
Yeah, that's true, too.
And I have an interesting stat to you.
Okay.
Baker Mayfield, you think he's pretty good, right? You know he didn't beat one winning team?
Well,
he didn't beat one.
Really?
All the teams he beat had losing records. Mm.
He came busting out of the trailer park and did good.
But I don't know if I can emphasize this so much, but when you play in football, you got to beat winning teams. He didn't beat one.
Even with the rookie NFL record, 28 touchdown passes.
Still didn't matter. If you're throwing against one team, it sucks. Let's call it like it is. I mean, he may be good and inspirational, but who he beat, they were all losing teams. I don't know how you weigh that. It don't add up to me. It's smoke and mirrors. You got the sunglasses on, so I know some of it's hidden. But you didn't beat one winning team.
Wow. Wow, that's interesting.
Yeah, they won 7 games.
Is that all?
Yeah.
Wow, I think they'll win 10 this year.
Okay. You heard it, folks. Bet the under on that.
So the Steelers, I think the Steelers in Cleveland, and but they've got to watch out for the Ravens, and you got to watch out for Cincinnati. Don't count
Why?
Cincinnati out.
I'm counting them out.
Because they got the red rifle. Andy Dalton.
I don't hold him up there like you do.
I love him. If he didn't have
I like red, the red hair.
If he was blonde hair, he'd be a Pro Bowler.
I like the red hair, but I don't like the results. There's a lot of oh, I'm choking here. Sorry.
Well, he got new coaching
staff.
That
should help.
Now. Yeah. So
that should help a little bit.
So it could be a tough division. You know, it ain't a cakewalk anymore. But I think the difference is if Big Ben stays healthy, the Pittsburgh Steelers got a good shot, you know.
Well, so. I think Big Ben will stay healthy. He got the same lineman coming back.
Yeah. Who's that rocket scientist the Steelers got as a backup quarterback? Is he going to do any good this year?
Dobbs.
Is he Dobbs. What's he doing?
What color is he?
Yeah. We ain't claiming him yet. We ain't claiming him yet, brother.
Smoking, Jim.
You claim him?
Yeah, I claim him. He's a rocket scientist. Well, we got a little carried away, folks. I hope you enjoyed the show. Time's running out here. It's Smoking Jim Frazier here, as usual, his hilarious, honest self. Just don't bet with him, please. Don't bet with Smoking Jim. I'm Al Levine, the Talking Machine, ready to call it a good night. And please stay Joey strong.